The promotional machine is in motion for the OnePlus Nord, with new teasers seeming to pop up daily. We've seen interviews, trailers, short clips, everything popping up on our timeline, and the latest promotional video certainly gave us reason to smile, especially with those huge historical moments, the intense emotions in the filmmaking, and of course, the super intelligent sounding narrative.
It's not about revolting against the past.
But ultimately, we're talking about a cheap smartphone.
I'm really sorry, guys. I'm going to have to stop Tony right here. OnePlus has just announced that the OnePlus Nord is due to be officially announced with an augmented reality event on July 21st. Yes, it is now official. OnePlus says you'll be able to use its app to view the launch event in AR on July 21st, and the app will be available in iOS and Android. But they're also producing some sort of physical invitations to the event, and OnePlus says it will give people some sort of unique hands-on experience of the device in AR. Physical invitations will contain a QR code, and all of that is in line with what we have seen so far, the leaks on Amazon in India.
So putting the razzle-dazzle aside, extremely good marketing is of course important in 2020, especially in the tech genre. However, parking the theatrics, two pieces of information did come out that really reveals OnePlus plans.
So look, OnePlus's revelation of the Snapdragon 765G included in their handsets is really a sign of, well, you most likely will get 5G connectivity with the OnePlus Nord. And this fact alone is a massive advantage over all the mid-range model or most of the mid-range models that you can find out there. But how important is the 5G connectivity to you guys or to me, like the potential buyers? Well, it appears to be really on the rise. Well, you know, it's not for the coverage or for the connectivity as of today, but it is all about being future-proof. You and I, we want to be future-proof as potential buyers of the OnePlus Nord, or in fact, any phone that is out there. And that is the reason why people really look for the 5G connectivity as of today. And the phone becomes then way more relevant when you have it for a couple of years, because you just simply don't need to upgrade. And looking at the pricing, there's really some strong indications that this will come in below $500. I have seen reports that say $299, and this is a crazy price for a handset that offers 5G and so much more. But there's a strategy behind that. And in business-to-business and B2B, it is called land and expand.
It simply means you get your foot in the door to prove exactly what you have to offer, whether that be now or your future roadmap. It is an excellent strategy for OnePlus, and super clever if they are throwing in their earbuds at the same time and a bundle with their TV, throw some ecosystem toys into the mix, and the proposition becomes even more tempting.
And here is what we know so far. On the bike, you can expect a triple rear camera. You can see the megapixels here for yourself, but you also have that dual selfie camera coming in a nice little punch hole on the left hand side. 90 hertz refresh rate, fingerprint sensor, and I wanted to touch quickly on the 6 GB of RAM, because the Geekbench results show 12 GB, and I don't think the 12 GB is really relevant or represent the entry level phone we will see from OnePlus here. Turning around the OnePlus Nord, we have the touchscreen, the Super AMOLED touchscreen, we have the measurements, pixels, and one thing I would like to mention is that it doesn't have a headphone jack as we know as of today. However, you know OnePlus, this may change overnight, and there's going to be an announcement later today.
On the other hand, OnePlus is only launching the Nord in Europe and India, and then moving on to some sort of beta program in the US.
And apparently Europe and India are seen as the core markets for the OnePlus family. And you know what? This fact alone could really reveal why OnePlus has chosen to like launch an Uber mid-range phone in these markets. When you look into the story a bit deeper, OnePlus has recently really downsized a lot their regional offices, namely in UK, Germany and France, by 80%, and this is massive. Some countries only have skeleton teams of 3 people left over, and that is really a sign of what is going on with OnePlus here in their core market.
Let's face it, OnePlus have really been struggling to expand further than their finite number of fans, and this could be due to the fact that they have alienated a lot of their fan base by shifting towards premium devices. And returning to their roots and back to basics, OnePlus is releasing the Nord on pre-order, and this is how you get yours.
OnePlus has already taken some pre-orders for the OnePlus Nord on July 1st, but not to worry, there's another slot opening tomorrow. Today's the 7th of July, tomorrow's the 8th of July, and you can see 10 o'clock CET. It will open in all the countries I'm going to list down here on the bottom. The next round, however, if you missed that one, there probably will only be a couple of hundred available. There will be another round on July 15th, and that will be for 24 hours. It is probably wise to sign up for a OnePlus account. It just makes it easier. The down payment is £20/euros, and you know what? They're going to start sending you awesome merch. That's what it says. And tomorrow, the slot is really only for a couple of hundred. But what it says, though, for the first two rounds, and we missed the first one already, if you are in for the second one, they will send you some really cool merch immediately. And they say the first and second round pre-orders will come with a random lifestyle product, a sticker pack, and other mystery gifts you will not get on the third round. So guys, let us know in the comments below, should we get the OnePlus Nord? I'm kind of intrigued and curious about what you guys think. Thank you for watching. Jens here from Also Space, and Tony, of course. Peace out.